Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Marcelle, the Marcelle. Please subscribe to the channel, like this video, comment on this video, hit the notification bell so that you are notified every time I upload, and don't forget to share this beautiful video. To my OGs, my regulars, Sanbonani, Dumelang, Jirkupayahere, Ikoko, it's your girl, Marceline, and you know how we do on this channel. Okay guys, today's video is mainly for my first year baby. So if you got a sister that's a first year, a brother that's a first year, a cousin that's a first year, you still need to keep watching this video because it is indeed for you. Okay guys, so today we're gonna be talking about registration, we're gonna be talking about staying in a residence, and we're gonna be talking about during your degree. So first of all, registration. This depends on whether you are an international student or a local student. If you are an international student, then there is an international levy that you have to pay on top of the registration fees. Please do go to your university website in order for you to know which is which. And if you are from a certain country and from a non-certain country, under University of Pretoria, where I attend, it differs. So make sure you go to the school website, you click on registration, online registration, and then you click on registration fee and you will be notified of everything. Make sure you read it thoroughly because this is very important. You cannot register for your degree if you do not do this. And because you're a first year, you need to read thoroughly. Okay? Okay. And then also when it comes to registration, there are specific requirements that are expected, especially I know for international students, before you even go to online registration, you need to have sent in your study visa, you need to have sent in your full medical aid and your passport. This is just so that they have these things, and I don't know, it's a requirement for international students, so just do it and your holds will be removed. You can freely register online for your modules. Okay guys, also when it comes to your study visa, if you are a first year, make sure you are constantly checking on your study visa if your visa has not yet come out. This is so that you will know if there will be any delays and you can email the university prior to the final date for registration and they can make certain exceptions for you if it is a universal problem. Okay guys, that's all for registration. Actually, no, don't you dare. I forgot something. Also, when you are registering for your modules, please make sure you read your yearbook thoroughly. Make sure you know the codes for your modules, and if you don't memorize them, write them down somewhere, or whilst you're registering for your modules, have your phone on the yearbook so that you know which specific modules you need to be taking, which co-modules and elective modules. This is very important. Okay, then now when it comes to res, at my university we pay for res separately. So you pay for your tuition separately, you pay for your rent separately, and then you also pay separately for food and accommodation in the residency. So there will be specific amounts. In order for you to know exactly how much you need to pay, you need to also type in accommodation and then you type in res, and then you find out for your specific res where you are staying, how much is it for a first year student. Okay, this will depend. For my university, they have double rooms and they have single rooms. The single rooms are for the seniors, and then the double rooms are for first years, just so that they encourage you guys to, you know, make friends and stuff. So you will be staying, of course, with a roommate. And yeah, just check the prices so that you know you're on top of that. Depending on the year, the prices will differ. Okay guys, that is it for this. No, don't you dare. I keep forgetting. The last thing is use the facilities that are available to you. You have a printer, you have computers, you have laundry. For my university, we have laundry. You have so many things available to you. Please, guys, you are paying for these things. You need to use them to the fullest. Don't break them, okay? But use them, okay? Yeah, so make sure you use all the facilities. And I would say, if you're staying in res, you're not gonna need a lot of stuff, so that also saves you money because your groceries won't be that much because you're already getting food from the dining hall. Although now, because of this pandemic, I don't know what that looks like for those of us who stay in res. Okay, now I'm done. Okay, now for the durings. Whilst you are studying, please guys, utilize the consultation hours for your lecturers. Also, if there are any tutors available, use those tutors. If there are no tutors available, considering that we are in a pandemic, then there are tutoring companies that will assist you. I know for my university, there are many tutoring companies that assist people. That money that you would have used to buy your textbook, that you know, you're gonna end up looking for the PDF, because we cannot be using so much money, Malengak, for a book for 1.6 that you only use 3 pages of. Be smart, okay? And yeah, you can use that money to pay for a tutor who will help you, because yo guys, these are foreign things to some of us, to most of us, so you need to be on top of your game. So as well, utilize the emails, guys. Like, if you don't understand something, email somebody. Go to the website, email. If it has to do with registration, you look for the right people to email. If it has to do with res, look for the right people to email. If it has to do with your module, look for the right people to email. Because guys, you do not want to just leave something and then figure out like this could have been solved with an email. If they're not answering the emails, call them, okay? Unenginan for Nell. Washa. Unenginan for Nell. Washa. You have enginga, you must for Nell them, because if you don't, you're gonna regret it. But yeah guys, that is basically it for this video. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. I hope I helped my first year babies, and that you go and tell your nieces, your nephews, your cousins, your aunts, your uncles that are first year students, that are unsure, unaware, that are scared. It's alright. It's okay. You're gonna figure it out. This video is gonna help you. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you made it this far and you didn't subscribe at the beginning. You are suspect, but it's okay. We forgive you on this channel. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. Mwah.